The American military launches a full-scale public attack on Tucker Carlson.
The Pentagon has attacked now Tucker Carlson by name. A senior enlisted leader in the U.S. Space Command attacked Carlson by name, and I've never seen that before.
The Pentagon and some of the most senior members of the military are slamming a Fox host tonight for saying pregnant women serving in the armed forces are a mockery of the U.S. military. I wonder if he just does that just for attention. But
well, now the American military has decided to apparently embrace the standards of political correctness. And not just political correctness. They've decided that the top brass in the military are now going to focus their fire on public relations fights with journalists they don't like. Which is quite astounding. Imagine if under President Trump, top members of the American military, having heard slanderous things about them for years from the left-wing media like MSNBC, had decided, you know what, one day we're just all going to go hard out after Rachel Maddow. Rachel Maddow says something about the military, and the entire military brass decides they're just going to go directly after Rachel Maddow. Now, cries of authoritarianism would have been deafening. The cries of fascism would have been deafening. Why is our civilian-controlled military speaking out as an independent body and suggesting that it should be in competition with members of the private sphere? And one of the great things about America is we do have civilian control of the military. The military does not control the military. The civilian branches of government control the military. And guess what? We all get to have opinions on how the military is used, whether or not we have served. And none of that, again, is a referendum on the bravery of the people serving.
Did you enjoy that part? If you did, then give me a like.
So on Monday, when we saw Joe Biden pledge to bring a, quote, intensity of purpose and mission to really change the culture and habits of the U.S. military, we paid attention to it. Creating maternity flight suits. Maybe those suits had been around for a while. We'd never heard of them. But here was the president of the United States promoting them at a press conference. And that phrase stuck out. Not because we have some hateful bias against pregnant women flying military jets. We're pro-pregnancy, as we often say. We're also open-minded. Maybe pregnant women make the best pilots. The Department of Defense measures everything, so there's got to be extensive research on this question. If the Pentagon can show that pregnant pilots are the best, we will be the first to demand an entire Air Force of pregnant pilots.
The bottom line is that civilian control of the military is one of the hallmarks of American democracy. And one of the other hallmarks of American democracy is that the military does not speak out as an independent body against members of the civilian sphere. In fact, it is a regulatory violation for members of the military to do this. They're allowed to have private-based opinions. They're not allowed to speak on behalf of the military in members in matters of public policy. So all of this began last week when Tucker did a segment talking about how Joe Biden had been out there bragging about how they have these brand new uniforms for pregnant women. And the general point that Tucker Carlson was making is the point of a military is to be efficient, is to break things and kill people, basically. That the job of the American military is to make America more secure. And typically, when you're talking about the military, that is through the threat or use of violence. And top priority for a body that is designed to do this is not, in fact, the design of new uniforms for pregnant women. Like, that's nice that they have designs for uniforms for pregnant women, but this isn't exactly like the bleeding edge of what you need from your military. If you're talking about what you need from your military, it is more firepower. It's excellent troop cohesion. It is high levels of efficiency in being able to threaten or to perform the act of breaking things and killing people, right? That's what the military is there to do, or to preserve the peace with the threat of breaking things or killing people.
The Education Ministry of China released a notice entitled Proposal to Prevent the Feminization of Male Adolescents. The goal was to, quote, cultivate students' masculinity. Have you seen this on other channels, by the way? Kind of interesting, isn't it? China won't explain the reasoning behind this plan, but there are some clues. Last year, we learned that China has quickly developed the world's largest naval force. In 2015, China had 255 battle force ships. Now they have more than 360. And many of those ships are more capable than anything in the American naval fleet. So how are we responding to this? Well, at the White House yesterday, Joe Biden addressed it effectively. What's the American military's response? Here's what Joe Biden said.
You know, some of it's relatively straightforward work, where we're making good progress designing body armor that fits women properly, tailoring combat uniforms for women, creating maternity flight suits, updating updating requirements for their hairstyles. And some of it is going to take an intensity of purpose and mission to really change the culture and habits that cause women to leave the military.
So we've got new hairstyles and maternity flight suits. Pregnant women are going to fight our wars. It's a mockery of the U.S. military. While China's military becomes more masculine as it's assembled the world's largest navy, our military needs to become, as Joe Biden says, more feminine, whatever feminine means anymore, since men and women no longer exist. The bottom line is, it's out of control, and the Pentagon's going along with this. Again, this is a mockery of the U.S. military and its core mission, which is winning wars.
And so Tucker says, you know what, if we're talking about top priorities in the military, the top priorities in the military ought not be the maternity leave policy for pregnant women. It's great they have that, but that is not top priority. And why you have top members of the administration touting that as like, this is the most amazing thing happening within the military, as opposed to here is a retrofit of all of the obsolete equipment that the military requires to be replaced, right? That should be top priority. If you're talking about maternity leave, then maybe you ought to look to, you know, some of the other federal agencies, if you even want to do that. By using the military as an instrument of social engineering, or at least pretending that the top priority of the military is social engineering, is bizarre and does not make us more competitive. And the world came down on Tucker. How dare he say this? He's sexist. It's terrible that he's suggesting all of this. Right? How could he? And then what's worse is that the military decides that they are going to get involved in this. This is the part where things get really wild. So according to the UK Independent, a top military official at U.S. Space Command has hit out at Tucker Carlson's comments against women in the military, pointing out the host has never served a day in his life. Well, that is true about everybody. I mean, Joe Biden was not in the Army. So the hell what? And Joe Biden, who's announcing the policy, was it? None of Joe Biden's press team was in the Army. And what are we talking about here? None of those people were Marines. So the hell what? That's not relevant. There's not a single host on MSNBC, so far as I'm aware, who's performed military service. That's fine. They're entitled to their opinion, and Tucker's entitled to his opinion.
Thank you for watching that video. If you like that, remember to give me a thumbs up and subscribe right up here. For other great content, take a look at our recommended video over here and see our playlist right over there. Remember to go to www.dustyfriday.com for great memes, news, videos, and my podcast available on all major platforms. Thanks, and we'll see you on the next one.